Senator Goldwater, what does liberal mean now in American politics?
Well, liberal means, to me, means a person who is willing to keep on trying political answers that have never worked in the past, like socialism, like the federal control, things like that.
You agree with that definition, Senator McGovern?
No, you wouldn't expect me to accept that. I think liberalism is an innovative, experimental approach to government. It's also a humane and somewhat generous approach to government. It's deeply concerned about people that aren't as fortunate as Barry Goldwater and I have been.
Would you say that, the key difference between a liberal and a conservative has to do with the way people view the role of government?
I think that's probably right. For most of the time, at least since World War II, we've had a more or less bipartisan foreign policy. So liberalism versus conservatism doesn't have an awful lot to do with foreign policy or national defense. What it has to do with is the role of government in meeting people's problems, particularly people who are somewhat handicapped, children, for example, who aren't in a position to meet all their own needs, dependent women, the poor, the handicapped, the sick, the homeless. To me, liberalism does a better job of reaching out to people like that. It doesn't mean that they're against the middle class or against the upper class. In fact, I think those classes do very well when liberals are in power.
Yeah. Senator Goldwater, what do you think of Senator McGovern's definition?
Well, I would agree with it, but I just offer as an example of what can happen. Look at the farmers where my friend lives. And from federal control of 30% of the farmers has practically destituted the farmers of this country. Those farmers who did not come under federal control have been doing very well. So I go back to the old idea, the conservative doesn't want to try the failures of the past. We want to make our progress on what we know has worked in the past, but we'll try anything new.
But what about his point about humanity, that there is a element of humanity that goes with liberalism that is not there with conservatives?
Oh, I disagree with that completely. The Republican Party way back in the days of Lincoln recognized that if the people could not take care of each other, the state or the county could not take care of each other, then it became the duty of the federal government to take care of those people who could not well take care of themselves, nor take care at all. But the expanded role that the liberal government has gotten into, frankly, is the big factor of our being so much in debt.
If I could just pick up on what Barry Goldwater said about the farm issue. He makes a good conservative argument against any kind of federal intervention on agriculture. But the fact is, these farmers, particularly the family farmer, the guy that depends on his own labor to make a living on the land, most of them can't make it without some kind of government program to stabilize farm prices.
In this particular election, Senator Goldwater, there's been the suggestion, around the edges at least, that to be a liberal is to be somehow a less patriotic American than a conservative. Is that true in your opinion?
It's not true in my opinion. Now let's look at these two gentlemen running for president. George Dukakis is a true American. He's a loyal American. He's worked hard. He's been a governor. George Bush has worked hard. He's a vice president. He's been head of a number of organizations in this country. I think they're both honorable, patriotic, dedicated Americans. And I don't like this idea that's starting to creep around both camps that the other fellow's no damn good because he doesn't agree 100% over here or 100% over here. Let's have him admit that this thing is a race for the presidency of the United States. It's not a race for the most popular man. It's the man that's going to do this country the most good.
Do you believe that Michael Dukakis is a liberal, Senator Goldwater? Does he qualify for your definition of a liberal?
I would call him a liberal, but I'm not going to insinuate that he's a no-good you-know-what because he is a liberal. I know some of the closest friends I've ever had in the Senate were liberals. I just prayed maybe I could influence them, but I didn't.
You know, the interesting thing about liberalism to me, and I would say this to some of my fellow Democrats who seem to be running away from it as though it's a kind of a swear word, is that virtually every program that we now have on the statute books that most Americans support, I would say that Barry Goldwater and George McGovern could probably get together on most of those programs. Those began as liberal initiatives over conservative opposition. Take Social Security. Mm-hmm. Ronald Reagan's about as conservative as you get, and yet he says he won't touch the Social Security system. But when it began, virtually every conservative in the country was against it.
Why has liberal become a swear word, Senator?
Well, I think it's partly because of the Vietnam War. Now, let me explain that. The Vietnam screwed up just about everything in this country, including liberalism and conservatism. But what it did to the liberals was to give us an unpopular, expensive war at the same time that we were running the Great Society program, which was also expensive. And you couldn't run those two shows at the same time. It was too big a burden on the taxpayers. It created too much inflation. The interest rates were too high. And it created a very unpopular situation. Barry and his colleagues blamed a lot of those economic problems on the Great Society. Actually, the war in Vietnam had as much to do with the unpopular inflation and all the other economic difficulties that we had, as did the Great Society program.
So, the word liberal just automatically means a negative to most people.
It got associated with both big spending under the Great Society and then the big spending in the Vietnam War. The liberals were involved in both of those enterprises. So were the conservatives, but the liberals were in power during most of that period.
You agree with that clause?
I couldn't agree more. I think the Vietnam War was the stupidest damn thing we ever got into. We had two presidents who ran that war that didn't know how to run a war. And I agree with what George has said. It became a very unpopular cause, and it did contribute more to inflation than any other factor that we were confronted with at that time. And we're still paying for it.
So, Senator Goldwater, when George Bush says Michael Dukakis is a liberal out of the mainstream of American politics, and he gets a responsive chord, that doesn't surprise you, right?
No, it doesn't. I've been through that battle so damn many times, I would hate to think about it.
Yeah. There's an interesting thing about this popularity angle in liberalism, though, and that is this. When you ask the individual American whether he favors, let's say, rural electrification, or Social Security, or student loans, or Medicare, by margins of 2, 3, or 4 to 1, maybe 10 to 1 in some cases, they say yes. Well, those programs are the guts of American liberalism. So liberalism, because I think of a lot of political propaganda, has come to be a term that carries some rather odious connotations, and yet the programs that it's responsible for generally are endorsed by the American public.
But, Senator Goldwater, it's good politics, is it not, to say you're a conservative and to attack somebody else for being a liberal? That's just simple facts of life right now, right?
Well, that's what we're talking about, politics.
You bet. I mean, you agree that just as a matter of political course, to be labeled a liberal, a McGovern liberal even.
Yeah, that's the worst kind.
That's the worst kind of liberal there is. But, I mean, that's a negative in American politics. The question is whether or not that's a deserved negative. And you think it is, right, Senator Goldwater?
No, I wish they'd quit it. I wish they'd start talking about the issues. How are we going to solve this god-awful debt that we have in this country? How are we going to put forth, execute our foreign policy and keep out of war? These are the things that the American people want to hear. They don't care about the Pledge of Allegiance. We all pledge allegiance. Or prayers in school, we all do that. I wish we'd get this presidential race down to talking about the issues and forget about cussing a man out because he happens to be a conservative or a liberal. George and I have been through that.
I want to endorse what Barry has just said, but you know, one of the things that I think confuses a lot of people these days is conservatism. We've talked a lot about liberalism here tonight, but if it's true that Barry and I don't have all that many differences anymore. When you talk about Ronald Reagan and George Bush over the last 8 years, they are both conservatives. I think you'd have to say they claim the conservative label. And yet, during the time they've been in office, we've increased our national debt 2.5 times, more than all the other presidents put together. Now, I'm not one to blame them 100% for that. After all, we had a Democratic Congress during part of that time, and they went along with it. What I am saying is that it's a little hard for the American public to know what a conservative is when a celebrated conservative like Ronald Reagan presides over a huge deficit financing operation of that kind.
Is that a good point, Senator Goldwater?
No, I don't think it's a good point, because while I agree with what George says is true, we've got more people working today than we ever had in history. The economy is in better shape. I'm not saying it's going to be that good 6 months from now, but everything is going along pretty good in this country, and pretty good in reference to ourselves and the world. I'd like to forget this conservative liberal thing. I'll have to admit that I'm probably more responsible for having triggered this whole thing off in this country, but I was just raised to think that the role of government should be smaller, that the application of the welfare clause in the Constitution did not mean feeding, clothing, and educating. It meant the general welfare of the country. So we start off on two different premises, but that's no reason to have people cutting each other up, running dirty ads, dirty talks. God knows I lived through that, and so did George.
There's a kind of a meanness in this campaign that I don't like, and I know Barry doesn't like, and I suspect most of the American people don't like. I applauded George Bush's statement in his acceptance address when he talked about a gentler and kinder America. I'd like to see a little of that spill over into the campaign rhetoric. We have an awful lot of problems before this country. It's still the greatest country in the world, but it's got a lot of problems, and we need to approach it with a little more tolerance and amiability.
But, gentlemen, the way this campaign is being run right now is working. The negative campaigning, the use of labels and all that, Senator Goldwater, as long as it continues to work, isn't it going to be continued to be used? This is a matter of simple politics.
It's a question of whether the two candidates are willing to stand up and admit that each one of them, the other one, is a patriotic, dedicated American. Bush is inclined to be conservative, Dukakis is inclined to be liberal. But I think the people ought to salute both of them for having been willing to devote a large part of their lives to the furtherance of their state government and their federal government. And then once they've made that proclamation, start off and run a good, clean campaign and talk about the issues. Let the American people, you tell the American people what you think is wrong with this country, and if they agree with you, they'll go out to help you.
I think one of the unfortunate byproducts of this kind of emotional name-calling that's taken over so much of this campaign is that you do lose sight of the issues. Pretty soon it becomes a contest in who's got the best military record and who has the strongest position on a kind of an emotional issue like the abortion question, and you lose sight of the great problems before the country, the environmental degradation, the problems of this huge deficit, our relationship to the Soviet Union. Let me just put it to you this way. I think that if it turned out, it's not going to happen, but if Barry Goldwater and I were running against each other, there wouldn't be all this meanness in the campaign. We wouldn't be assailing each other on grounds of character and personality, but the voters of this country would see that there are some clear differences of opinion, and they'd know there's some issues that are worth arguing about, and that's what I think the American people want.
You agree, Senator Goldwater?
I agree 100%.
All right, let's leave it there. Gentlemen,
George, let's run against each other.
All right.
Just
why
for
not?
The hell of it.
We'll show them how it ought to be done.
Okay. Thank you both very much. And good luck in your campaigns.